Now the second task, which is the servo motor, we need to control a servo motor using Arduino. So this circuit I already demonstrated, so I already also drawn this circuit in another project. So let me open that project. So now we will be doing the servo motor project. So this one is actually the main circuit, this is the servo motor. To take this servo motor component, you need to write servo. If you write here servo, then here two things are available. So we will need the first one, we will be using motor PWM servo. So this one, animated PWM control servo motor model hobby servo. So you need to double click on this or OK. Then this will be available in your component, and you need to drag those component here in this environment, and you need to connect this like just like this. And also this potentiometer connection I already demonstrated in task 1, so I'm not demonstrating this now. The code, so you know, for this circuit we will be using the example code. So file example servo sweep. So if I go there, file, then example, then here servo, here so servo, then first code sweep. So in this sweep code, what you are doing, basically you are sweeping the value. That means you are changing that angle one by one. So first of all, let me demonstrate the code. So include servo.h, so you are including servo header file. So in the servo header file, there are different functions or other codes that are already written, and we will be using those codes. So servo my servo, that will basically create a servo object, and using a servo object you can attach a servo motor with your board. So this is a variable declaration, integer position equal to 0. So position is basically the angle at which we will be placing our shaft. So in this void setup, this line my servo dot attach, so through this line we are saying that we have attached our servo at pin number 9. So that's why my servo dot attach 9. And then in the void loop we will be using two for loop. So in first for loop we have started from position 0, and we have an increment of plus 1, and then we have gone up to 180 degrees. So in each step we have increased the position value by 1. So initially it was just 0, then after the second iteration it will be 1, then 2, then 3, up to 180. And each position will be right, will be written in our servo motor. That means servo motor will rotate. That means initially it is let's say position 0, then it will be at position 1, then position 2, so up to 180. That means the shaft will be rotating from 0 to 180, let's say clockwise direction. So this is the first time it will rotate from 0 degree to 180 degree, and right after that you will have a rotation from 180 to 0. That means you are coming back to your home. So initially it was position 0, so you have gone up to 180 degree, then you have started from 180 again, and you have reduced that position. So position equal to position minus 1. That means you are decreasing that position degree, and you are decreasing up to 0 degree. So through this process you are writing that value in your servo motor. So let me verify the code. So it is now compiling, and it is done compiling. So if I go there and copy the directory, this one, control C, and import yes, double click there, and I already written here anyway, so control A, then control V. So I just showed the program file location. Now I am clicking on OK. So now the code is uploaded. So if I click here, run the simulation. Now if you notice, it is doing the simulation. That means it is going from minus 90 to plus 90, then again it is coming back from plus 90 to coming leftward, after minus 90. So in the simulation, actually the degree is written from minus 90 to 090, plus 90. That means the difference is actually 180 degree. So the servo can rotate up to 180 degree, and in one cycle it is going from minus 90 to plus 90 one by one, and in a second cycle it is going from plus 90 to minus 90. So that was our code. And if you notice, we are not using that potentiometer in your sweep code. So in your sweep, that is the first code that I just uploaded, you don't need this potentiometer. So you can just connect that servo motor to pin number 9 and all things are operational. And our second program is basically, there is another program here. So first of all, I just done this file example servo sweep, and there is another which is knob. So we will be using a potentiometer, and we will be reading that potentiometer value and change the servo position according to that potentiometer value. So this code is already given from example. So file, then examples, then servo, then knob. So this one, if you click on this, so the knob code is available. And if you notice in this code, and the first portion is similar, and this is the port pin 0, that means A0, since we will be using the analog pin. So if you can write 0 or A0, both will be okay. So this will be the potentiometer pin. And also in this circuit here, if you notice, we have connected the potentiometer with A0. So this is fine, I can say. So this one, so port pin A0, and second one is the value. So a variable I just declared to read the potentiometer. So in the void loop, if you notice, value equal to analog read of port pin. That means it is reading the potentiometer value, and then it is using another function, first of all map. So what does map does? It will map your value. So first on the val, that means the value we will be mapping. So we will be mapping that value that is just read, and we'll, and you know that value is 0 to 1023 range, because the analog read of Arduino generally read the values from 0 to 1023 range. And obviously in this rotation, that means my servo.write, I just previously in your sweep code, you have probably noticed that we have given from 0 to 180, right? So that's why we can't write 1023 in your servo motor. You need to write it from 0 to 180. That's why we have mapped those values from 0 to 1023 to 0 to 180. That means if those value is 1023, then it will be converted to 180. Just simpler mathematics. And if that value is 0, then it will be converted to 0. And let's say if that value is 512, that means almost half of 1023, so it will be read as let's say 90 degree. So that will this function do, map. That means it will convert this range 0 to 1023 to 0 to 180. And what it will convert? It will convert the val value. So what will be read through this analog read? It will convert those value to 0 to 180. And then the myservo.write. So we will be writing that value to our servo motor, and then we will be having a delay of 15 milliseconds. So I just demonstrated the code. Now if you click on verify, so it is now compiling. So done compiling. Now this is the hex file that you need to show. So control C. And for this knob function, you generally need this servo motor. Sorry, not servo motor. You generally need this potentiometer. Now if you double click on this, and here this program file, so if you click and control A, control V, so just you have just short the program directory. Now click on OK. Now the code is uploaded. So if you click on this run this simulation, so now it is running the simulation. And if notice it is now at around 52%, and if you notice here, this is not rotating. Why? Because in the knob code there is nothing written that you will be changing the shaft position. What you are doing, it you are reading the analog read port pin, and then you are writing that value in your servo. That means it will be fixed, and this fixed angle you will be controlling using the potentiometer. So now it is 52%, and that's why it you can understand that this could be 0 to total 100%, right? So when it is 50%, that it means almost the middle position. So similarly, this is almost in the middle, that means 0 degree, and if you click on there, so it is almost 0%, and if you notice, it is almost minus 90 degree, and if you take it the highest value, so it will be plus 90. So you can understand that if you are changing this value, so this shaft position will be changing according to this potentiometer value. So if you increase like this, that value will also be increasing. So this is our second portion of our task 2. So this one is completed.